Hello everyone, I am Ki-seung Bang at Seoul National University. Today, I will introduce a new form factor of VR optics. Most VR devices have a form of a big headset. Therefore, VR users look like putting a big box on their face, which nobody would want to look so. Also, too far center of mass from the head prevents us from using VR for a long time. Then why do the VR devices have to be so bulky? Ironically, most volume of the VR devices is occupied by the air. This thick air gap between the display panel and the lens is only necessary to secure the optical path length. In usual cases, the thickness of the air gap is around 50 to 100 mm. In this paper, we present the glasses-like form factor of VR optics. Our new design only requires a very thin air gap. The necessary gap between the display panel and the lens is only 3.3 mm in theory. Our VR glasses prototype has a total thickness of 8.8 mm, including all necessary optical components and the LCD display panel. Now, let's look into the theory. Our design can be explained as a combination of the lenslet array structure and the flat pancake lens system. I will introduce them one by one. While the conventional VR has a single lens per each eye, our design has a lenslet array and the lens which are attached together. In conventional VR system, the single lens has to solely perform two functions at the same time, floating the image to a far distance and collecting the light to the user's eye. Therefore, both the thickness and the eye relief become related to the focal length of the single lens, and it ends up with the thickness that should be much thicker than the eye relief. In contrast, in our design, the two independent components perform two functions. That is, the thickness and the eye relief is not anymore related to each other. Therefore, the thickness can be designed to be much thinner than the eye relief. However, as the nature of the light field display using lenslet array, it is inevitable to sacrifice the resolution of the display. It is quite common in light field display to achieve only few percent of original display resolution. In this paper, we derived the optimal system parameters using light field analysis so that the resolution loss is only 50%. At the same time, we achieved only 10 mm of the necessary thickness, 102 degrees of the wide field of view, 10 mm of wide eye box, and 20 mm of the ergonomic eye relief. In practice, we chose to use Fresnel lens and Fresnel lenslet array to build the structure. Since they are thin, lightweight, full color capable, and low cost, it is an excellent selection for VR. However, since the Fresnel lens have practical aberration, they will affect the system performance of the design. For the best for performance, the lenslet array should be designed for the groove out collimation function, and the collecting lens should be designed for groove in focusing function. Fortunately, this kind of Fresnel lens design is the most typical design in off-the-shelf products. These two figures show the 2D light field at the eye box, for ideal case without aberration and practical case with Fresnel lens aberration. It seems like the Fresnel lens distorts the light field very much, but if we focus on the usable light field area, the effect of the aberration on the eye box is not so much. The eye box size shrinks by only 12% and we can still secure 8.8 mm eye box. Every other performance like field of view and thickness remains the same. Another important feature of our design is that we can apply flat pancake lens system, which is polarization-based optical path folding system. By adding four additional passive polarization controlling layers between the display panel and the lenslet array, we can make the light bounces back and forth so that we can secure the same optical path length with only a third of thickness. By applying this technique, we can further reduce the thickness of the lenslet VR system. 10 mm air gap is reduced to 3.3 mm. Again, every other performance like field of view and eye box remains the same. We built two kinds of prototypes. The first is the benchtop prototype. It includes an LCD, an off-the-shelf Fresnel lens, and lenslet array. In this benchtop prototype, the optical path folding is not included, so there is 10 mm of air gap. The video on the right side is the capture display result. The horizontal field of view was measured to be 102 degrees as designed. The vertical field of view was not able to capture, but it should be the same by the symmetry of the system. Eye box can be directly measured by capturing the result while moving the camera position. As designed within the 8.8 mm of the eye box, we can observe a fine continuous image at all positions. And when the camera deviates from the designed eye box, we observe a discontinuous image with crosstalk. The resolution was measured by capturing a resolution target. At the center, the MTF reader shows about 10 pixels per degree of resolution, which was enough to deliver the whole resolution of the LCD pixels. However, we observed that the resolution decreases in peripheral region. We believe that this can be improved in the future by optimizing the Fresnel lens. Secondly, we built a VR glasses prototype. Now it includes the pancake lens system, and we could achieve the total thickness of 8.8 mm. The thickness difference between the theory and prototype comes from the thickness of LCD, Fresnel lens, and lenslet array. If we assume the Fresnel lens and lenslet array can have the thickness of 0.5 mm each, the total thickness can potentially become 6.3 mm. As the only difference between the two prototypes is the pancake lens system, the two have all the same optical properties, such as field of view, eye box, aberration, and eye relief. However, we can observe that the VR glasses prototype has a little blurrier image and a lower contrast. This defect comes from the imperfect control of the polarization, and can be improved by more precise control. Summary: we presented a novel optical design for compact VR using the lenslet structure and the pancake lens system. We suggested optimized system parameters, considering performance trade-off. We built a glasses-sized VR prototype and experimentally verified the performance. Thanks for your attention.